Just a couple of years back, gaming enthusiasts had to sacrifice a lot if they opted for a gaming laptop on a tight budget. Constraints on aspects like build quality, hardware and all meant that the experience just wasn't worthwhile. However, that is gradually changing. In 2019, we saw so many great budget and mid-range gaming laptops, and I was fortunate enough to review some of them as well. I'll link them down below, so be sure to check them out as well. Now, 2020 is looking to be a revolutionary year for laptops because of all the exciting announcements that we saw during the CES 2020 a couple of weeks ago. And though folding and dual displays sure sound exciting, the thing that I was the most hyped for is AMD's new Ryzen 4000 series mobile CPUs. And while it is going to take some time for the Ryzen 4000 powered laptop to arrive in our studio, I have the next best thing with me today, the ASUS TUF FX505 GT laptop. This is a budget gaming laptop which is powered by a 9th generation Intel Core processor alongside NVIDIA GTX 1650 graphics. This has been my primary device for a month or so, and I genuinely think that this is one of the best in its class. But of course, ASUS has made some compromises for cost reduction. So let's find out all about this device in our review here. But before jumping into the review, I would like to share a recent experience at our office. We had just set up a new PC and it did not come with activated Windows. And while looking to buy an activation code, we stumbled upon cdkoffers.com, where we bought a Windows 10 Pro key for just $12. Insane, right? CDK Offers has a large selection of digital codes for Steam, Xbox, PC, Origin, iTunes, and so much more. You want it, they have it. Making payments is fast, secure, and easy as well, with a variety of payment options like PayPal, Visa, and PaymentWall. With their excellent return and refund policy and a 24/7 live chat service, their dedication to service is commendable. I mean, what more could you want? So visit cdkoffers.com for purchasing any kind of digital code and save 25% on checkout using our promo code. Now starting with the build material, the FX505 GT comes in an all-plastic body, from front lid to hinge to the back of the laptop with an aluminium future tank lid cover. There is definitely some flex to it, but it is not terrible in any way. Having said that, it is definitely not as sturdy as other costlier options, so durability could be an area of concern. But take some solace on the fact that it has passed a series of military-grade MIL STD810G tests, which ensures that this laptop can withstand high altitude, solar radiation exposure, including a couple of accidental knocks or drops as well. Onto the design, the lid has this converging speed lines with the ASUS logo in the middle, which I think gives off a fairly aggressive gaming aesthetics. And for a gaming laptop, its thickness is on par with others at around 1 inch. Moreover, thanks to the plastic build, the FX505 GT is fairly light at around 4.9 pounds or 2.2 kgs. The other thing that I liked about its design is the placement of LED indicators for charging, battery level and stuff. It is located right above the power button and is visible even when the lid is closed all the way. That's a nifty little design choice, which I admire nevertheless. Moving on to the interface and ports placement, all of them are located on the left side. You get one combo audio jack, two Type-A USB 3.2 Gen 1, one Type-A USB 2.0, an HDMI port which supports HDMI 2.0, an RJ45 LAN port, and the charging port. So if you are someone who makes use of most of these ports at the same time, you might fall victim of tangled wires. Talking about wires, the wireless options on the other hand on the FX505 GT include integrated Wi-Fi 5 and Bluetooth 5.0 connectivity. Now let's get into fan placement, which is crucial for any gaming laptop. The ASUS FX505 GT has two rear facing vents on the dual hyper fan. Its anti-dust cooling mechanism releases any dust particles accumulated. Additionally, you can also tweak the performance of these fans through the function buttons between silent, performance, or the turbo option. And as you might have guessed it, the turbo mode gets efficiently loud. The audio from the speakers of this laptop, as expected, is strictly average. You get 2-watt stereo speakers aligned at 45 degrees. You'd certainly benefit from using headphones, especially while gaming in turbo mode, because, like I mentioned before, the fan noise is very loud. But that's not all the reason for plugging in a stereo headphone. The FX505GT also supports DTS headphone X technology for immersive sound quality with optimized audio profiles for games, movies, and sports. The keyboard here is really impressive as well, which is a full-sized keyboard with single-zone RGB lighting. Here, you can customize the lighting from the TUF or a core panel. And I do have a single special mention to the WASD keys for their transparent and highlighted design. Since I am a content writer myself, I really enjoyed the keyboard on this thing with its good travel distance, satisfying soft tap sound, and an overall satisfactory typing experience. But on the contrary, the trackpad on the FX505GT is just about average. It is made of plastic and therefore is not as good as glass trackpads. This could have been better, but I understand that Asus had to cut costs any way possible without hampering anything critical. When it comes to the display, the Asus TUF FX505GT sports a standard 15.6 inches LED backlit FHD IPS panel, but with varying refresh rates. The unit I have with me has a 60Hz display with 45% NTSC color gamut, though you can also find one with up to 144Hz and 72% NTSC. The bezels are adequately small as well, though they are a bit more pronounced on the top and especially on the bottom of the display. Here you will find a 720p webcam at the top whose quality is just subpar. Hi guys, you're watching me through the Asus TUF FX505GT's webcam. How do you like the quality? Do let me know in the comments below and I hope you're enjoying the review. If you are, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Despite the inferior refresh rate and color accuracy, I am fond of this display panel, at least for its price range. Colors, contrast, and viewing angles were all fine by my standards. And though this is not the most color accurate panel, it still manages to outperform other similarly priced budget laptops like the Acer Nitro 5 and the HP Pavilion 15. Therefore, this is definitely not for the professional content creators out there, but occasional photo editing requirements are well within its reach. The brightness is decent as well, but not anything extraordinary. Due to this, I definitely had some trouble using this laptop outdoors. The performance is undeniably the biggest plus point of this laptop because the Asus TUF 505DD that we reviewed a couple of months back came with the 3rd generation AMD Ryzen 5 CPU, which was quite not there when compared to its Intel counterpart. As a significant upgrade, the FX505GT comes with a 9th generation Intel Core processor. My unit is powered by the Intel Core i5-9300H, while one with the i7-9750H is also available on the global market. Complementing the CPU is the NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1650 graphics card with 4GB of GDDR5 VRAM. With this decent setup at helm, I was able to play all the latest games in 60fps or more in the highest of settings. And for the optimum performance, I turned on the turbo mode with the fans maxing out on their capacity. For instance, I played FIFA 20 in the highest of settings with the MSAA option at 4x and it ran flawlessly. Battlefield 5 with max settings ran at around 55fps with no performance hiccups at all. Similarly, I also played Apex Legends Season 3 and it ran at 60fps under max settings void of any trouble. On top of that, there were no signs of extreme heating either. Apart from the turbo mode doing its job, that may have partially been because of the cold weather this time here in Kathmandu. And with such a commendable gaming performance, needless to say, the Asus TUF FX505GT handles other normal usage or general editing tasks with ease as well. Simultaneously using Adobe Photoshop or Illustrator with numerous tabs open on the memory-hungry Chrome yielded no issues at all. On the subject of memory, my unit came with 8GB of DDR4 RAM running at a frequency of 2666 MHz. That might be enough for general usage, but since this laptop is intended for gaming, I would advise you to add another 8GB stick in its vacant slot for enhanced performance. Furthermore, this one supports up to 32GB of RAM in dual channel, so there is always room for more. Similarly, the FX505GT that I have with me comes with 512GB of PCIe Gen 3 SSD storage. It was refreshing for me to see a budget gaming laptop with such big SSD storage. It has decent sequential read and write speeds as well, so I got no complaints on the storage front as well. The battery life, however, is not that great and falls under below average rating. It has a small 3-cell 48-watt-hour battery, which can last for about 4 to 5 hours in the most basic of usage, like web browsing or watching movies under silent mode. So that was our review of the ASUS TUF FX505GT. It is an excellent budget gaming laptop with a powerful processor and graphics card and a sizable SSD storage. It does fall behind in aspects like build material, but that is to be expected, I guess. It ticks all the boxes for an inexpensive gaming laptop or just a regular laptop for that matter. Therefore, I will highly recommend this to anyone who's looking for a decent gaming setup on a budget.